Hello and welcome to my next tutorial on DaVinci Resolve. On this one we are briefly going to cover transitions and then we're going to go into a few of the tool settings. With transitions, if you look at any good production like the Blue Planet, Our Planet, any professional underwater production, they are only going to use a simple cut or maybe a dissolve transition where it fades from one clip into the other. So, to get started, if you actually have your media pool window up, you see there are three icons here. There's a cut, which will basically reset something back to a simple cut, which we've already got, and then a cross dissolve, and then there's one more called a smooth cut, which is just strange, so we won't be using that. To do a translation, you just need to have your playhead in roughly the area, and then click on it. It's as simple as that. Now, at the beginning of our video, we have a fade from black into our clip of the mantis shrimp. They're set as 1 second transitions. You can make it longer or smaller if you want, but personally, I think 1 second's fine. If we go back to the beginning, we can now see this fade to black, fade in. So that is a simple cut. That's what we have done. What I am going to do is a cross dissolve in between every species. So, okay, we've got mantis shrimp going into cardinal fish, I think. Just gonna click on dissolve. Okay, then go further along, yet again, cardinal fish. Next thing, new species, click on that. Click on the dissolve. Same species, new species, dissolve. Same species, new species, dissolve. And then at the end, we can just click on dissolve again, and we've got a nice fade out while he shoots off into the background. So that's how simple transitions are for basic dive videos. There is a window up here to do other transitions, but they're all, in my opinion, they'll make your footage look horrible and cheesy. Just stay away from them. Like, you can play with them if you want, you just need to click and drag down, but I personally ignore them. The next thing we're going to do is a few little edits using the tools icon down here. If you click up this, you see there's a new bunch of tools that appear here. There's transform, which is all about the position of the clip. Crop, which then hides the sides. We need to use that. Audio, we don't need to do that because we've done our audio already. Speed, we can use to speed or slow down the clip, but we don't need to do that as well because we've actually synced everything to time. And this is a very good one, camera settings, which we can have like lens correction and stabilizer. The stabilizer is what we're gonna look at. So if we look at our first clip, you can see this mantis shrimp. There's a little bit of a wobble here from the camera. We can actually click on the clip, click on stabilizer, and we get a few more things pop up. There are three different stabilizers: the perspective, similarity, and translation. Perspective, I find, is a little bit wobbly and makes things all warpy and strange. I don't think it's designed for underwater work. So I tend not to use that and use one of these two, whichever one looks better. You can click on this. There are a few settings that you can change, but you don't really need to. I tend to leave these all on automatic. I don't normally change them. So all you need to do, click on either similarity or translation, and click stabilize. You'll see that it zoomed in a little bit. Now if you watch it, you'll see that there is no more wiggle. Everything's nice and smooth. You could even go one step further. If you have a bit of footage that there's hardly any camera movement that you've tried to be as still as possible, you can always try this one, which is the camera lock, which, yet again, click it, then click stabilize, will make it look like it's actually on a tripod. So if you look at this now, I don't think there's any wiggle whatsoever. We can then use our transform here, which you've got two things that we're going to use. Down here we've got like our zoom, and here we've got our position. So we can actually zoom in a little bit, don't go crazy, otherwise you'll start noticing that you're losing resolution. And then you can actually position them a little bit. So you can use the same like things you learn in photography, like the rule of two thirds, trying to get him down in the bottom left corner where the lines intersect and everything. And you can shuffle things around a little bit. So I think that's okay. A little bit of a zoom in, get him a little bit closer, a little bit to the left. So that's nice and smooth now. He's in a slightly position. Yet again, same again with this one. We can literally go straight to here, click on stabilize, let's camera lock it, click stabilize again. It's gonna zoom in, zoomed in on that. Go back to our transform over here. Let's zoom in a bit more on the eyes. I don't know, 1.25, I think that might be okay. A lot of these are gonna be on a phone or seen somewhere else on the web, so no one's gonna pick up that you've been zooming into your footage. So let's have the eyes smack bang in the middle. Okay, let's push in a bit more. Okay, so hopefully that doesn't make too bad when we do the render. So now we can see our mantis shrimp is already super still, zoomed in, very nice footage of the eyes. We can then just use these techniques on everything else, so I'm just gonna do that now. Okay, so that's all there is to it. I hope you've enjoyed this episode and I hope you continue watching this series. Thank you.